Frank Kern's giving a live video, and it's titled, "I'm So Sick of This Shit." What's Alex to really say whatever they want? And there's some respected ones out there. You have Citron, which I like, Muddy Waters, they have good track records, but there's a lot of used car salesmen out there, which is pretty terrible. So I want to break this down a little bit for you really quick. So when I look at the company fell 11%, fell sharply, but I want you to take a look at the disclaimer. When you look at the disclaimer, this is great. This is at the bottom of their report, right? Hindenburg Research, possibly along with all the members, partners, affiliates. So I'm right here, guys, just to show you, right here. Affiliates, employees, consultants, along with all of our clients, and or if it has a short position in all stocks and or options of the stock, that means they're short before the report comes out, covered here in it. And therefore stands to realize significant gains in the event that the price of any stock covered here declines. Okay, yes, we get that. Following publication of any report or letter, we intend to continue transacting in the securities covered herein, and we may be long, short, or neutral at any time hereafter, regardless of initial recommendation, conclusion, opinions. A lot of words there. What does that mean? It means that you're allowed to short the crap out of a stock before, right? Pre-market, right? So just ahead of everybody else. And by the time, right now that you're reading this and the stock's down 11%, they can actually probably cover their whole short position. It's perfectly fine. But it gets better. And these disclaimers are standard when you have a short sell. Hindenburg Research is not registered investment advice. This is not a hedge fund, guys. This is not a hedge fund. So they're not registered, no regulation. That's why they get away with this. What they're doing is 100% legal. It's just complete bullshit. And then the best part here is Hindenburg Research makes no representative express or implied as to the accuracy, timelessness, or completeness of any such information. So basically that's saying I'm full of shit. I could lie and say whatever I want. As long as I put in a disclaimer, it's perfectly fine. I could be short the hell out of a stock, come out publicly, which they have partnerships with so many of the websites out there, and put it everywhere. Usually lawyers, you'll see lawsuits as well. They go out right away. So they can announce this massive short campaign and tell you how this stock is going to zero. It's an absolute fraud. And literally when this stock comes out, and every time they do this, you'll see the stock fall. They build up their positions. You saw Nicole was falling before this. They build a position, and it crashes. So the stock crashes, and these guys, again, they could be long the stock right now. Who knows? But for something like this, if I did this, right, if I was going long and I took a massive position, I went on and took this little small cap and said, this small cap's at a dollar, it's going to 300 in 3 months. And I was completely long and I put a disclaimer like this, which I could do, put a disclaimer like this, the SEC would be all over me, right? So you're not allowed to do this on the long side. I don't know how you're able to do this on the short side because it's really terrible what they're able to get away with. But I want to get more to Hindenburg here. Again, their research is okay. They have a decent track record, some winners, of course. And this is where you know his firm's kind of full of shit, is when they say about us, they go over their track record. So when you're looking at their track record here, about us, who's Hindenburg Research, they did highlight April 20, March 20, and they talk about the stocks, their winners. That's great. That's awesome. Talk about the winners. What they're not going to tell you about is how come you're not posting this on that site, okay? This is where you're down the site for the company. New Pacific is a mining company. Actually shorted these stocks, same exact thing, did this whole entire thing, is crazy. And now they're looking at New Pacific to fall 90% downside, and also Silvercorp, who owns a stake in their mine, Silvercorp, to fall 29%, right? And this is from April 20th. Let's check it really quick. Let's have some fun here. So this is New Pacific. This is April 20th that came out, 536. This stock's going down 90%. Well, it's not down 90%. It's perfectly fine. But the best part of this is if you go to Silvercorp, Metals, which again, April 20th, they said that has up to 45% downside on April 20th at 336. Look where it is, 821. Okay. Now, if you're looking for legit people and people who do the right thing, again, if you want to look on our website, encourage your research. I have archived of everything I've wrote since I started this company. You're looking at all of our podcasts, every single one. Okay. Some of them are going to be losers. We all have losers sometimes. And we point out the losers and we mention them. But everything is there for you to see. That's called credibility. And when you're just posting on your website just your winners and here's our track record and you're not putting everything on there and you're allowed to do this with short sellers, I mean, it has to stop. There's a lot of bullshit in this market. It should be regulated. It makes almost anyone with a decent following being able to do this. Take a massive short position, basically cover it, and it doesn't even matter what their thesis is. And basically, they're telling you that all the research I have is complete bullshit. We have no idea if it's even reliable. Think about that for a minute. And you wonder why everybody hates Wall Street. I'm Frank Curzio. As always, I'll report back to you soon. Take care.